Namaste, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making misal pav. It is basically Maharashtrian cuisine and just like pav bhaji and other, I really love all Maharashtrian recipes. So this is one of them and today I'm going to share and I'm going to try to make it simple and quick and easy for you. So let's start. For this recipe, we need a brown garam. It is known as moth in India. We Gujarati call it mathia. It is basically brown beans and we need a sprouted one. So here I have them ready. And we need a sprouted dry peas. Today I failed to sprout them properly. So here I have them. I tried to cook a little bit so that I can use in this recipe. But basically you will need a sprouted dry peas. It's a mutton. And, of course, I have some onion and a tomato. Here I have fresh curry leaves from my garden. Onion, tomato, and coconut. And here I have some fresh coriander leaves, dhania, to sprinkle on the top. And of course, I will need some ginger, garlic, green chili, and some spices. So let's start. And I'm going to use a pressure cooker today so that it is quicker for me. So here I have this pressure cooker and I'm going to turn on the stove on a medium heat. So, and first I'm going to prepare the gravy of onion and tomatoes. I have already shared video how you can sprout your lentils or beans and all you do is soak them overnight or about at least 8 hours and then drain out water and keep them in a container which has a lot of holes because we need to have air going in to sprout them very well. So usually I use this sieve, but you can also use a sprout maker which is easily available and you can cover like this. So it's pretty easy to sprout your lentils or beans at home. Into this pot I'm going to add couple of tablespoons of oil. So here I have the sprouts, moth, or also known as matki in India. So this is how they look like when they are sprouted. Oil seems to be ready. I'm going to add a turmeric powder. You can add mustard seeds first, but I'm going to prepare the gravy in the same pot. So I'm going to leave it out right now. And here is the onion. And I'm going to cook this onion first. I'm also going to add some garlic paste, ginger paste. And usually in India, a lot of oil is used for this recipe, but I will just add as per my family preference. Okay, so let this hang out for a little bit. Here I have the dry peas. I cook them. I failed to sprout them, so I just went ahead and cook a little bit, but you can sprout them and then use in this recipe. Let's check on the onion. So you can see that onion is ready. And now I'm going to add this coconut. And I'm going to add this tomato as well. Now I'm going to cook tomato very well till it gets mushy so that I can prepare the nice gravy. I'm going to add just a little bit of salt. You can add according to your taste, salt. Okay, so now I'm going to let this cook and I'm going to cover it now. Let's check on our onion and tomato. And now once my onion and tomato is done, I'm going to use this blender to make the gravy, which makes more lot more easier for me. So let's check. And cooking great here. I can see that the tomato is also cooked nice here and almost got mushy. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn off the stove, or you can bring it down to the lowest temperature, add some water, and I'm going to make gravy now. Now if you want to follow this method to make gravy using the hand blender, you have to be a little careful. Make sure that it doesn't splash on you. So it's just better to turn off the stove rather than even keeping it on low heat. So I have already turned off the stove and I'm going to plug in this blender, the hand blender, and carefully blend this into gravy. What I normally do, I take it on one side like this and then try to make a gravy like that. All right, so here I have a nice gravy ready. You can see that. And if you wish, you can use other kind of a blender to make it kind of a very smooth paste. But this is how I like it, so it's good enough for me. Now I'm going to add my rest of the ingredients. Here I have this sprouted moth, and here I have this dry peas, so I'm going to add that. Out of this sprouted moth, matki, I'm going to add not all of it, because I'm going to use later for my other recipe. And this looks like enough for me. Look at how already it looks beautiful. Now it's time to cook this moth and that dry peas. It's already cooked, but I kind of like soft, so I'm going to cook this two ingredients well now. And before that, I'm going to add this red chili powder. Add according to your taste. Mine is not that hot, so I'm going to add about 1.5 teaspoon. And here I have this garam masala. And here I have this curry leaves. Usually you can add in a tadka like when you do in the beginning, but because I wanted to make the gravy in the same pot, I did not add at that point. And give it a good stir. We'll need some more water. So before I cover the pressure cooker, I just want to make sure that I have enough water so that moth, matki, cooks well. Cover it. And I'm going to hear about 3 whistles. 2 to 3 whistles are enough, because the sprouted lentil doesn't take too long to cook. And if you wish, you can just cook them in an open pot. So it's really up to you. But I wanted to make a quick version of it. And most of the time I use pressure cooker, and I love to use pressure cooker all the time, most of the time. I already heard 3 whistles, so I'm going to take it off of the stove, turn off the stove, and I like to cool down naturally, or you can place it under the cold running water, under tap water. But I'm going to keep it on the side and allow it to cool down naturally. Pressure cooker has cooled down naturally, and just would like to share that this misal pav is very similar to seosol. I usually prepare seosol, and I also serve, even though it is served just with a namkeen on top, sometimes we serve with the bread. So misal pav and seosol, for us, both of them are almost similar, but in misal pav, this moth is added, the sprouted one. And here I have this plate that I'm going to prepare this. I'm going to show you how you can serve this misal pav basically. So take out all the air, and I'm going to show you how this looks like now. So carefully open it up, and look at this. Oh gosh, look at the color, it looks so gorgeous. We usually have this namkeen we call sev, besan sev. We make at home, and we make in a big quantity, so we always have this on hand. But you can use any kind of namkeen. Namkeens are usually sprinkled on top for seosol and this misal pav. But if you don't have any, then you can just eat without any of this namkeen even. It tastes so great. This sabji itself, this curry itself, it's so much flavorful that you can just eat with bread or any kind of even your homemade bread. It doesn't have to be any particular bread even, but usually the buns bread is used with this misal pav. Give it a stir. The aroma is so wonderful even. Now if you wish, you can add a little bit more water to make it more gravy, but this is perfect for me. And I'm going to take out into this bowl here. Water is coming in my mouth. All right, look at this. On the top, sprinkle some coriander leaves, dhania, and I'm going to sprinkle some onion as well. And of course, this namkeen. Just like that. And here I have this lime. And look at this plate, looks so yummy. Going to keep some more namkeen on the side. Look at this plate, looks so inviting, and I'm going to give it a bite of this curry. Just itself tastes so great. Can't tell you how good it is. You can also squeeze out the lemon or lime, and you can add also a little bit of sugar if you wish, but just as it is, tastes so great because of the sourness of tomato. Even you don't need even lime or lemon, but if you wish, you can. So this was all about misal pav, quick and easy and healthy version. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with the next great recipe.